They said it couldn't be done. I mean, I don't really know or care what they said, but they said it couldn't be done. They said that there is no such thing as Notion subtasks. Well, I'm here to show you they were wrong and I made it happen. Thank you. Thank you. So here you go. So first and foremost, we have a database that is just a task database by itself. It does not need more than one database for the system to work. And then I have two different templates, a main task and a subtask template. Opening up this task right here, this is set to the main task is the default template. And what this looks like is the following. We got a linked view of subtasks coming right in. So if I put an example name, daily chores, and I filter this, you'll see it's already got all these down here as a subtask. Then if I put it as daily chores, save for everyone, everything within here will relate to the daily chores task. So if I put clean bathroom, I put take out trash, all of these are going to auto relate to what it's filtered to, and they're going to be subtasks. Post recording edit Demetri here. If you actually make the template have the main task contains the template for main tasks, then when you make a new one, it'll actually auto filter for the new task that you made. As you see here, I will change the name and it will actually auto make this the new main task. Back to your regularly scheduled programming. So then from there you may be saying, okay, but how do I get it to tell me that everything's complete? So the logic that I have in this formula essentially states that if there are no subtasks within here, so say I deleted these really quickly, this formula is going to spit out no subtasks. But if it has subtasks and none of them are checked off, then it will say not started. But if it has one checked off, it will say in progress, or two. But if all of them are checked off, it will say completed. But also in the same vein, if I do this, it will also say completed. And how this works is it takes a bunch of different formulas that I ended up making. So all you need to do is you need to have a subtask and a main task relationship by creating a relation between your own database. Have the main tasks side of it be filtered to just one page and have the subtask option be as many as you want. So all you gotta do is relate the database to itself, have a subtask and a main task one. And then this is a subtask aggregator, which essentially says, when I check all of these off, it'll say no from the task rollup that comes from subtasks. This pulls in the task checkboxes. And then I have a yes, no here, which essentially says that if any of these contain yes from this task rollup, then it'll check it off. This guy is asking whether the subtask relation has anything within it. So then based off of all those formulas, that's how you get this logic to work, because the way if functions work in Notion is that it goes in the order that you put it in. So since the first one is no subtasks, if I take these out, it'll pull in that logic and say, okay, there's no subtasks, which as you can see is based off this checkbox. And then if any of them checked off, I'll get in progress, because the other ones I put is if this guy is checked off, it's all done. If all of these are true, it's all done. But if it's somewhere in between there, that's where you get the in progress, because it's not any of the other logic that exists within the formula prior. And then when it comes to subtasks, the database that I have in here is a linked preview of the main task database. And then all this one is set to is a set as default to a subtask. So this is just going to have like a what to accomplish section if you want to add any sort of other sub notes to it. And then some example daily planner filtering for this could be, so I duplicate this main task view, main tasks daily planner, I could have it so that this filters also to where all task status is not completed with the checkbox there. So then say this happens, it disappears. Say all three of these guys get checked off, this would disappear. All right, you're not gonna believe this. After I finished recording this video, Notion came out with a progress bar update, which essentially takes the percentages that you used to have in Notion and allows for them to be turned into either a progress bar or a circle that shows a progress with a percentage. So with the subtask template that I just made, it perfectly aligns with this new concept. So what you need to do in this circumstance to make it happen is add a couple things. So first, what you wanna do is you wanna make a subtasks percentage and then put a little parentheses rollup. And then this rollup is going to take the relation subtask, take the task checkbox. You're going to click on calculate and change it to percent checked. So as you'll see here, this is the percent checked is zero of the subtask. If I put this, it'll have 33%. So then what you need to do from there need to duplicate this and just change the name to subtask percentage, and then change this from the rollup to a formula that grabs that name. So you're going to do subtasks percentage rollup, this property in there, edit this property to be a percent. Now, what you might be saying is, all right, well, why aren't you just going here? But the problem is you need to make a progress bar that factors in whether this is true or not. Because if I just do this, it's not going to change the progress bar situation. So what you need to do is you need to duplicate this, call this progress bar, and then put in if property task checkbox equals true, then return one so that it'd be 100%. And then if else, just return the subtask percentage by putting this here. So then what we can do here is we can go edit, and you can either have a bar showcase and you can change the color here. I like making it blue, or you can make it this ring. So if I do this, you'll see that it kind of is blank here. So let's complete something. You'll see it ends up factoring in 33% of it. So what we could do is get rid of this number here and then show this ring option. And that's another way that you can look at it. So what I would recommend is that you hide these subtask properties. And then as you can see, this is an override for making it complete. So once again, we can go here, we can edit the property back to the bar. Let's say I add another subtask, take the dog. You'll see the progress bar changes. And if we check this off, it'll go farther in it, and it'll even show you when you hover it what percent out of 100 it is. But then if we get rid of all of these, and this was just a main task, it would override it like this. And it even does the same thing for this circumstance, because remember, the subtasks also exist too. If I check this off, it shows the progress bar for the subtask, because if you could, in theory, make a subtask inside of a subtask, I don't want to get into all that. I think it's a little gratuitous. But the way that this formula works is super easy. If you want to get this template, make sure to go to riseproductive.com/notion templates to get this database. And also check out my services if you're open to being a consulting client of mine. And check out this video to see how you can improve your Notion even more.